Hello everybody, my name is Subtony, and as you can see, welcome to how to install Gale Mod Manager and how to install mods with this mod launcher. So first, I'm assuming you have an archive utility tool such as WinRAR or 7-zip. So I'm assuming you already have that. For me, I'm using WinRAR, so as you can see, I've already have it installed. So yeah, just do that and then let's download Gale. First, we just have to search at Google Gale Mod Manager. Enter and then click the first link. It should be the thunderstore.io. So it should be under that URL. And then we scroll there and click manual download. And then I've already downloaded earlier. So let's just go to the folder. And then let me just delete this for a sec because it's confusing. So we just have to right click this, click WinRAR and extract to this one, the third option. So I'm gonna click that and it will now extract the folder. Double click this and then you have to install this MSI installer. So just right click, open. And it will now, so don't be alarmed with this one, just click more info and click run on anyway. And it will now install Gale Mod Manager. Just click next, install. That's pretty much it. And then you can also untick this or not, but I'll leave it ticked so it will automatically open Gale. So after we click finish, it will now open Gale, right? So this is Gale Mod Manager. So you will be prompted with this welcome screen. So we just have to scroll down and find our game. For this example, we're gonna use R.E.P.O. Just click R.E.P.O. and then just click next. And then welcome to game. Then close this prompt and maximize it. Currently, we have selected in the default profile where we can add more mods, where we can install. But first, we need to install this Weapon X pack. So this is a mod where it will enable other mods to be played on your modded repo, basically. So you need this in order for all the mods to work. So just click this and then install. And then let's go back to manage profile. Now it means that we've already installed Weapon X pack. If we click this, we can also see its details. You can also close this. If you want to uninstall this, just right click and click uninstall. So yeah, that's pretty much it. And then on the right side, this is where you disable a certain mod. So if you click this, this means this mod is disabled, but it's still installed, but it is just disabled. Just click this again to enable the mod. Now for the next step is that we're now going to install more mods. So let's go to the second tab, the Thunderstore mods, and then search for new mods. To find popular mods, we just have to go to this column and then click rating, and you'll see the most popular mods for this game. So first we have to install certain mods, such as maybe you could search this one, library, for it to add more content for R.E.P.O. if you want that. I also would recommend this as well, and this is also one of the mods that you would need as well in order for mods to load faster. So I'm gonna install this, and then those are pretty much it. Now you can also install this R.E.P.O. config. This is basically a mod menu on the main menu of the game, so you can also install this, and that's pretty much it. Now let's also install more players. So this is one of the popular mods where you can configure certain number of players in a lobby. So in the vanilla version of the game, you can only play up to 5 more people in a total of 6, right? But with this mod, you can play up to 20, I think. Oh, it seems at 100. Okay, that's crazy. So we just have to click install, and now it's completely installed. As you can see, every time we install the mod, there's a check mark right beside the name of the mod. And you can also install this late join, one of the best mods out there, where after you finish doing the shop section of the game, you will be in the intermission section, the truck section basically. And once all of you guys are on that section, you can invite players to join the ongoing game. So yeah, that's a pretty neat mod. So I'm just gonna install this as well. There's also other mods such as Wesley's enemies, which you could find the droid if you've watched a couple of YouTube videos and streamers out there. This is one of the popular mods out there where the lost droid mimics a player but isn't actually a player. But yeah, so yeah, this is a pretty good mod as well. Yeah, I guess there's also the Minecraft level mod. You can also install it at your own free will. So yeah, there's also Freddy. Good god, this is a pretty scary mod if you ask me. And one of the best mods out there is Chicken Jackie. Okay, that's pretty much it. Okay, now let's go back to our managed profile, and as you can see, this is a list of the mods that we've currently installed. And oh, just right in queue, there's a new update, so you just have to click update all, and it seems that Minolib has a new update, and then just click update mods, and now the mod is updated. So that's pretty much it. Now let's start the game. So in order to start the game with these mods, you just have to click launch game. But before that, make sure you have Steam. So I have Steam here, and as you can see, I have R.E.P.O, right? So make sure your Steam is open and you owned R.E.P.O. That's pretty much the requirement, basically. So we just have to minimize Steam and then launch the game via Gale. So click launch game and it will launch R.E.P.O from Steam. Okay, now here we are, the modded R.E.P.O. So as you can see, the mods button is now here, and a couple of mods are listed here as well. Not all of the mods will be listed here, by the way, so don't worry about that. So yeah, you can just host the game, just click yes, and yeah, you can start a new game and invite friends, basically. So that's pretty much it, guys. Once you close the modded R.E.P.O, you can just click X this, and then you'll notice that on the third section on the side navigation bar, there's edit mod config, where you can also edit some config for each mod, basically. So for more players, we can actually set this to 15, so you can also do that if you want, and then just click enter. That's it. No save button, it's just automatic. So what if you want to share all of these mods to your friend, but you don't want to guide them one mod at a time? So you can actually click export and click profile as code, and once you click it, a code will be generated. Just copy this and then close and share it to your friend. Once you've shared it to your friend, they can actually import it. So as you can see, just imagine I'm this friend, okay? So I'm gonna import this code from my friend, and it's your choice if you want to create this as a new profile or overwrite existing profile. So I'm gonna import this, and that's me overwrite, and as you can see, all of the mods are here. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Now let me do another import with another set of mods. So I'm just going to import another one, click profile from code, and paste this, and click import. Now I'm going to create a new profile. So I have this mod list that I have, and it will install all of these mods. So just click import, and it will automatically install all the mods based on that mod code. And once that's done, then you can also update if you want. Just update all of these mods, and then that's pretty much it. If there's a new update, just update it right away. And if you want to change profile, you can just click this. So this is the current profile, just click it, and then you can change it to default or mods or the second one. So this is a great way to change modded R.E.P.O. So if I click launch game, it will now launch with all of these mods. But if I select default, it will only launch the game with all of these mods instead. So yeah, just click this and then launch the game. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I guess I covered all of the important stuff. And yeah, thanks for watching.